Joselappa, namaste and good morning everyone. It's me, Sumitra Maharjan, an English teacher of Mangal Secondary School, Kirtipur Municipality, Ward number 10. Today also, I'm speaking on this Newa FM 106.6 MHz radio education program conducted by Kirtipur Municipality, broadcast by Newa FM Anok Media. First of all, I want to heartily welcome one and all listening to me. Especially, welcome to Class 8 students with your textbook, pen and notebook. I hope all of you are aware of COVID-19 and taking necessary precautions. Dear students, let's move to our today's class. Do you remember our previous class? Yes, we discussed about the exercise of good habits. Now, turn to the page number 111, Unit 11, Games and Sports. Engage yourself. Here are some questions. Let's discuss on it. How often do you play games? How often do you play games? I play games daily. I play games daily. Yes, we play games daily. Now the second question is, how do your parents support you in sports? How do your parents support you in sports? Do they buy things for you to play with? Do they buy things for you to play with? My parents support me in sports in various ways. Your parents also support, yes? They buy things for me to play with. I like football very much. They give me money to buy football shoes, socks, jersey, football, etc., which I need. Sometimes they also buy different things for me. They encourage me to take part in several games, competitions, etc. They allowed me to watch sports channel on TV. Now look at the pictures and answer the following question. Look at the pictures. Okay, look at the pictures. Dear students, there are the pictures, yes? There are the pictures. There are four pictures which are related with sports. Do you see? Yes. Okay, the people are taking part in different types of games and sports. The people are taking part in different types of games and sports. Now, in the first picture, look at in the first picture. In the first picture, two boys are playing chess. Do you see it? Yes, two boys are playing chess. Now, look at picture number two. In picture number two, the two men are jogging. What are they doing? Two men are jogging. Yes, two men are jogging. Now, in the third picture, there are three boys. Yes, there are three boys and a ball. What are they doing? Yes, they are playing football. Are they playing football? Yes, they are playing football. Now, in the fourth picture or in the last picture, what are they doing? What are these two women doing? Yes, two women are playing basketball. Do you see? Yes, two women are playing basketball. Yes. Now the next question is, how does chess sharpen your brain? How does chess sharpen your brain? Chess sharpen the brain. Yes, the chess game sharpens our brain. To go from one step to another step, it is necessary to think about the result of moving. Chess is a game of strategy. The games of chess has shown to yield a number of cognitive benefit in children and elderly alike. Chess boosts brain power of kids. Chess has shown to enhance visualization skill. Chess improves IQ. Yes, chess improves our IQ. Chess enhances arithmetical skills also. Arithmetical skills. Chess hones verbal skills. Chess sharpens critical thinking. Critical thinking skills. Chess boosts emotional intelligence and psychosocial skills. Chess preserves mental equity in the elderly. Okay, these are the answer of this question. Now, before reading the passage, now we will go through the passage. Before reading the passage, first of all, we must know the word's meaning. Yes, we must know the word's meaning. Let's read the word's meaning. Are you ready, my dear students? Are you ready? Okay. You all repeat after me. Okay, are you ready? You will repeat after me. Are you ready? Yes, very good. Now, listen carefully and try to write in your copy also. Okay, note copy also. Okay, listen carefully. OBCT. OBSITY, OBCT. OBESITY, OBCT. OBCT means fatness. OBCT means fatness. Now the next word, patriotism. 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 Patriotism means love of your country. Love of your country. PATRIOTISM. Patriotism. That means love of your country. In Nepali, Desh Bhakti. Who love the country? Desh Bhakti. Okay, now the next word. Metabolism. 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 Once again. METABOLISM. Metabolism. Metabolism means the chemical process in living things that change food into energy. Metabolism means the chemical processes in living things that change food into energy. Now the next word is integrity. 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 Integrity means unity. Yes, integrity. 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 Integrity means unity. Unity. Okay, now next word, brief. BRISK, brief. BRISK, brief. Brief means quick. QUICK, quick. QUICK, quick. Now the next word, are you listening, my dear students? Are you listening? Okay, very good. Next word is diplomacy. 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 Diplomacy means skill in dealing with people without offending them. Diplomacy means skill in dealing with people without offending them. Okay, now the next word, alert. Alert. A-L-E-R-T, alert. A-L-E-R-T, alert. Alert means watchful. Alert means watchful. Now the next word, virtue. P-I-R-T-U-E, virtue. P-I-R-T-U-E, virtue. Virtue means moral excellence. Moral excellence. Now the next word, sleeplessness. Sleeplessness. Sleeplessness means inability to sleep. Inability to sleep. Now the last word, anxiety. Anxiety. A-N-X-I-E-T-I-E-S. Anxiety. Anxiety means the state of feeling nervous or worried. The state of feeling nervous or worried. Okay, these are the words which are related in our passage. Okay, do you need to repeat these words? Okay, I will repeat once again. Please listen carefully and try to write it also. Obesity. Obesity. O-B-E-S-I-T-Y. Obesity. Obesity means, okay, can you say the meaning of obesity? Obesity means fatness. Yes, fatness. Now the next word, patriotism. Patriotism means love of your country. Good. Love of your country. Can you spell the word? Can you spell the word? P-A-T-R-I-O-T-I-S-M. Patriotism. Yes, patriotism. In Nepali, can you say the meaning of that Nepali? Deshbhakti. Good. Deshbhakti. Metabolism. Can you spell the word? मेटाबॉलिज्म MetaBOLISM मेटाबॉलिज्म। मेटाबॉलिज्म मीन्स द केमिकल प्रोसेस इन लिविंग थिंग्स दैट चेंज फूड इंटू एनर्जी। द केमिकल प्रोसेस इन लिविंग थिंग्स दैट चेंज फूड इंटू एनर्जी। नाउ नेक्स्ट वर्ड विच इज इंटरग्रिटी। यस इंटरग्रिटी। इंटरग्रिटी मीन यूनिटी। इंटरग्रिटी मीन यूनिटी। नाउ द नेक्स्ट वर्ड ब्रिस्क। ब्रिस्क मीन क्विक। BRISK ब्रिस्क। ब्रिस्क मीन क्विक। नाउ द नेक्स्ट वर्ड डिप्लोमेसी। डिप्लोमेसी DIPLOMACY डिप्लोमेसी। डिप्लोमेसी मीन स्किल इन डीलिंग विद पीपल विदाउट ऑफेंडिंग देम। डिप्लोमेसी मीन्स स्किल इन डीलिंग विद पीपल विदाउट ऑफेंडिंग देम। अलर्ट। अलर्ट मीन वॉचफुल। अलर्ट। अलर्ट मीन वॉचफुल। वर्च्यू मॉरल एक्सलेंस। मॉरल एक्सलेंस। स्लीपलेसनेस। स्लीपलेसनेस मीन्स इनएबिलिटी टू स्लीप। इनएबिलिटी टू स्लीप। एंजाइटी। एंजाइटी। एंजाइटी मीन द स्टेट ऑफ फीलिंग नर्वस और वरीड। द स्टेट ऑफ फीलिंग नर्वस और वरीड। ओके डियर स्टूडेंट, यू ऑल्सो रीड दिस वर्ड मीनिंग मेनी टाइम्स। ओके नाउ लेट्स मूव टू आवर पैसेज। लेट्स मूव टू आवर पैसेज। टर्न टू द पेज नंबर 112. Okay, in 112 there is a passage. Yes, there is a passage. Read the text below and give a suitable title. Okay, after reading this passage, we have to give a suitable passage. Okay, are you listening? Are you listening? Okay, now I am going to read the passage. Please listen it carefully. Okay, then we will give a title also, suitable title also. Okay, listen carefully. Games and sports keep one physically and mentally fit. They keep one away from disease relating to the heart, obesity, mental stress, and sleeplessness. They instill in the player a spirit of self-confidence, self-reliance, discipline, justice, fair play, and patriotism. Games provide us with recreation and enjoyment. Okay, now let's move to second paragraph. Next paragraph. Games keep our body alert, active, youthful, and energetic. Games increase the circulation of blood, boost metabolism, burn calories, and improve respiration and digestion. Healthy people can work hard cheerfully for a long period of time. They can face danger boldly. They enable people to follow other virtues like discipline, honesty, integrity, loyalty, and patriotism. Now, next paragraph. While playing games, various exercises are performed automatically. Brisk walking, Running, cycling, skipping, swimming and yoga are common activities to keep fit. Mild exercise help patient recover from heart attack, diabetes, blood pressure, etc. Exercise invigorates us. Games provide us with recreation and enjoyment. Football, cricket, lawn tennis, or wrestling are watched by millions of fans all over the world. When we watch and play games, we forget all our worries and anxieties. They enable us to divert our mind from wrong thinking. Sports help people to face challenges in life bravely. Players are not deterred by failures because they know that failures are the stepping stones to success. Such an approach would help one recognize one's skill. Players develop team spirit. They learn to adjust with other people's shortcomings. They respect and follow the rules of the games they play. Sports persons display punctuality, diplomacy, and self-discipline. Are you listening, students? Okay, now next paragraph. Games are very essential for the students. Okay, listen carefully. Games are very essential for the students also. In our school, however, games and sports are not given much importance. A period of half an hour or 45 minutes should be dedicated to games every day in school. Some schools dedicate this time for games only once a week. Children find it difficult to purge a game in the specific period. Some schools cannot afford fund for sports equipment. Similarly, some schools do not have a playground. Many schools do not employ a physical instructor to guide the children in various games. Even parents want their children to complete their homework assignments after school hours rather than play games. They fail to realize that games make children strong with mentally and physically. Many school children become obese due to lack of participation in games. Obesity put them in the high-risk category of contracting diseases like diabetes, heart ailments. The education system needs to be reformed and equal importance needs to be given to sports and games. Okay, this is a passage, complete passage, yes? Now we have to give a suitable title. Okay, do you think a suitable title which is related with our passage? Okay, I think that importance of games and sports in students' life. Importance of games and sports in student's life. Okay, in this way you also choose a suitable title. Okay, you have to think. Okay, these are the passages of games and sports, importance of games and sports in student's life. Now in next class also we will discuss about this passage and we will do this exercise. Okay, now you also read the passage very carefully, okay, and think one of the suitable titles. Okay. Okay, this much for today. I hope you will enjoy today's class. We will meet next week at the same time. Stay home, be healthy and safe. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.